Texting is no doubt a fun and convenient way of communicating, so
let's not ruin it for everybody and use it as a passive-aggressive weapon.
And it happens so often, we may not even notice we're doing it. So to learn how to not become a passive-aggressive texter, we turn to etiquette expert Thomas Farley, a.k.a. Mr. Manners. First up, watch your punctuation, people.
You have to be very careful with how you use your punctuation marks in general, but in particular, how you use periods. It's very easy to read into someone's text that the fact that they've used a period means that they are indicating the opposite of what they're actually saying.
For example, he says if you type thanks with no period, that should imply you are grateful. But thanks, period,
indicates that you are being sarcastic or that you're actually not that grateful.
Next up, don't use texting as an easy way out. Put in some effort.
I think both our actual handwriting and our ability to compose a complete and coherent sentence have really fallen by the wayside, and texting is largely to blame.
For example,
so maybe you don't want to bother to send grandma a thank you note, so you send grandma a thank you text for your graduation present.
So,
next time you have a special occasion, grandma, instead of actually sending you a present, maybe she sends you a gif of a present.
Touché, grandma. Finally, don't leave someone hanging with a read receipt.
So with most operating systems, you have the ability to allow the sender of a message to see whether or not you've read the message.
And while Mr. Manners thinks this is a considerate gesture, be careful with it.
If you are allowing that message to be broadcast out, that you've seen and processed the message, or at least looked at it, and you're taking hours or even days to respond, that indeed is passive aggressive.
So he says either take off the feature on your phone or text back in a considerate amount of time, saying YES to texting considerately and putting passive aggression to the side.